All right, guys, today's menu is, we call this apan-apan. It's a specialty here in our rural area, and it's the favorite of Ron. You know who he is. Anyway, these are the ingredients. Main ingredient is, we call this in Tagalog, kangkong, but in our area, we call it tangkong. Okay, so that's what it is. We have garlic, onions, and what's that one, Ling?
Garlic.
There's also garlic, okay.
Vinegar.
We have vinegar, of course. That's the vinegar. And then, most importantly, we have we call it bagoong. It's kind of like a shrimp paste. And this is gonna be so yummy, guys. So how many ingredients? Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know me, noted for a few ingredients. Okay, we're gonna start cooking. Apan-apan, okay. All right, now, so we have the frying pan. We put some oil. Okay, yeah, it's heated now. So we're gonna put some oil. There we go. All right. And then, next, my trusted homie here is Ling. He's the one doing all this. There's the garlic.
And then we'll brown.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna brown the garlic. So the garlic is brown, now we're gonna add the onions now. Well, when you use the kangkong, the kangkong here in our area, we call it, we use both the leaves and the soft stems. So at first, we put the stems so that, you know, it's going to be cooked first. There it is. Cook it for a few minutes ahead of the leaves. All right, now the bagoong, we kind of mix the bagoong with some water so that it's not gonna be lumpy. So there it is, there's the bagoong, about half a cup, I think. There it is. So no need for salt because the bagoong is already salty. And then, yeah, you add a little water too.
Mm-hmm.
To cook the kangkong stem. And then we let it boil and then simmer it for a few minutes to really cook the stems. All right. To cook the stems, we have to simmer it for about, 10 minutes tops. Okay, guys, so the stem is now cooked. After we simmered it, now we add the leaves. I guess it doesn't take long for the leaves to be cooked. Whoa, you guys, you gotta try this. So it's really healthy because it's just mostly vegetables. The bagoong is made out of shrimps. Small shrimps that they process. But this is the one of the delicacies here in our area. And my husband Ron, you know him, he longs for this when his mom was still alive. She always cooks this every time he comes home. So I think he's coming home today, so we're making this for him.
Add the sugar.
Add a little bit of sugar, not a whole lot, Lynn, because you know, some of us are diabetic, so we watch our sugar. Just to offset the saltiness of the bagoong. And then the last step is to add the vinegar. Mm-hmm. Alright, I told you the last step is the vinegar. It depends on your taste, really, how sour you'd like it to be. For us, it's a couple of those. This is considered like a side dish. If you know, you have your main dish, whatever, and then you have your carbs. This is the side dish, or really an appetizer for me. So guys, here's the finished product of that apan apan, I'm telling you. And this is the whole breakfast of champion. There's the little rice, and here I have the aloe cake here. So I'm gonna enjoy this, guys, okay? Isn't that awesome? All right, hang on. So we're gonna enjoy a breakfast, guys. That's Eling, Eliza. And she's the one who cooked the apan apan. Okay, so we're waiting for Imak, my other sidekick here. Hurry up. She said she has to put on her lipstick, so. Okay, there she is. Okay, guys, let's eat. We're gonna enjoy this. All right, come on. Okay. All right, guys, here's our apan apan. Let me taste it. There's, it is. Okay, come on, let's see. Guys, it's delicious. But with this, I'm just sorry to tell you guys, because with this apan apan, it is really, it doesn't taste good unless it's eaten with rice. Rice is a staple here in the Philippines. And then here's our aloy.
Fish
aloy. That's so yummy. I have a very fond memory of this with my mom cooking it every time. All right, so, and we have our rice cake, puto. All right, puto is male. And what's the female version of puto? It's up to you guys. Okay, bon appetit. Bye-bye. All right.